Hey everyone, welcome to Jada with the Tea. I am your host Jada, and I will be giving y'all the tea on all the latest celebrity news, gossip, and entertainment news. So sit back and relax and get ready to sip this tea, honey. Okay, y'all, let's get into topic one. Have y'all seen the video going around, the viral video of the African-American girl named Treasure, who's on Dr. Phil, saying that she's white and she's not African-American because all type of crazy things that came out her mouth and the reason why she can't be African-American? Y'all have to see the video. The video has went viral. It's crazy. It's ridiculous. It made me feel some type of way. I'm an African-American young woman, and I was offended by the video. I can't believe the words that were coming out her mouth and the things she was saying about African-Americans. But I'm gonna give y'all a little black backstory on basically what happened and what was said out of Treasure's mouth. So the little girl Treasure, she's a teenager, she's African-American. Her mother brought her to the Dr. Phil show because she goes around saying and she believes that she is white. On the show, Treasure's mother said, "I don't understand why she believes she's Caucasian, because I'm African-American and her biological dad is African-American." And then Dr. Phil goes on to ask Treasure, why does she believe that she's Caucasian? And, quote, Treasure says that she is not African-American because she has naturally straight hair and her hair is not nappy, and her hair doesn't require weave. So that's why she's not African-American and she considers herself Caucasian. She also says that because I have pretty skin and my face is pretty and my hair is pretty, so I'm not African-American. She also goes on to say that that she doesn't have a giant nose like African-Americans. Her nose is small and petite, and so she can't be African-American. That her lips are not too big and not too small, they're just right and they're pretty, so she can't be African-American. And she then goes on to say that most African-Americans speak ghetto, and when it comes to black people, I think they're all ugly and I have nothing in common with them. I'm different from African-Americans because I'm white. These are the words that are coming out of this black young woman's mouth. Like, where did she learn this? And who told her it's right for her to say these things? Her mother supposedly brought her to Dr. Phil to help her stop saying these things and to stop going around saying she's Caucasian, and to stop using derogatory terms and stop saying ignorant things about why she's not black. She has all these stereotypes in her head of black people, and she thinks that she's not black because all black people look this one way or act this one way. Like, no, that's racist thinking. And because of thinking like that, we get judged on a daily basis and we're stereotyped on a daily basis as criminals or other things based off the color of our skin. And for someone of African-American color to sit here and talk about their own kind that way, that was just crazy to me. That was ridiculous. I can't believe the things coming out of my mouth. I was just shocked. I was offended. I'm like, this is so crazy that this has to be a scheme. Like, they have to be plotting. This can't be real. I felt that this was all a plot for Treasure to get on Dr. Phil to act a fool so she could become famous. Because ever since the Catch Me Outside girl, y'all know who I'm talking about, the Catch Me Outside girl was on Dr. Phil, all these young girls look up to her, and now they want to be out here acting a fool, fighting, saying all type of crazy stuff out their mouth, being ignorant or disrespectful. They don't care. They want to be out here acting a fool so they can get on Dr. Phil and say, oh, they want Dr. Phil to help them, but really they just want fame. Because they know the camera's rolling. They know people gonna see this. And they know people gonna come and say whatever they have to say to them and find them on social media, which is not gonna do nothing but bring more attention to them. That brings them more views, more fans, more followers. And they getting money off of this. Ever since Dr. Phil has released the video has went viral. This young girl followers have shot up. This young girl Instagram page has been hacked twice now because she has that many followers. This young girl done made a YouTube channel so she could get money to have people follow her so she could talk about why she feels the way she does and why she thinks she's white. This young girl has had multiple people already comment on all social medias of hers wanting to fight her because of the things she has said about her own race. And then there's another YouTube video that has went viral of Treasure's older sister, who was not on Dr. Phil, and she is exposing her little sister Treasure and her mother for putting on this act because she knows Treasure doesn't feel that way nor think that way, and that this is an act she's putting on to become famous so they could be on TV. And she's mad that her mother even went along with this and even allowed her to go on Dr. Phil. She says there's nothing wrong with Treasure. Treasure does not feel that way. She says, she goes on to even say that her mother doesn't even have custody of Treasure. She says that Treasure doesn't even go to school. Says Treasure is running from DCF. They've been looking for her because she does not even go to school. But they're on Dr. Phil making this whole story up so they can get money and fame. And she says she doesn't want to be a part of that, and she can't believe that they did this, and she doesn't want to be associated with them. But she felt the need to expose them because what they did is wrong and crazy. And I believe her. I believe them. I think they did do this for money and fame. It's so many young girls that have been doing crazy stuff, been trying to get on Dr. Phil. And I'm mad that Dr. Phil even allowed this and even allowed them on his show. Like, when you heard this ignorant miss, when you heard that ignorant miss come out her mouth, Dr. Phil was just like, how could you say something so ignorant and disrespectful? But why even put her on your show, though? You know that she acting a fool. And you know she trying to get fame out of this. She don't want no help. They made this whole thing up to get fame. That's just crazy. Like, anybody will do anything to get fame. To become famous. Like, I just think that's ridiculous. What y'all thoughts on this? I just couldn't believe it. It's crazy. It's still going on. Still viral video going. She's still making posts. She's still talking crazy. Like, she just wanted attention. And we don't need to give it to her. We don't. Because it's not going to do nothing but make her even more famous. But I just want to give y'all my thoughts on that. What y'all think about it? I think it's so crazy. I don't even know. I can't even find the words. It's just ridiculous. All right, y'all. Let's take a quick break. I'm going to play Tiana Taylor, Never Would Have Made It. And we'll be right back with the next topic.
Everything, my mama told me everything I know. You are the highlight. Mommy.
Yes.
Listen.
All right, y'all, topic two. So, I don't know if y'all know about the YouTube star Chris Sales and the child star Parker McKenna. They've been dating on and off for however long now. And Parker and Chris, they've been on off so long, it's ridiculous. But Chris is known from Queen and Chris of YouTube. They were a celebrity YouTube couple. They were married. And they got a divorce because Chris was exposed for cheating on YouTube by a whole bunch of different women. And after Chris and Queen broke up, he got with Parker McKenna. And their relationship has just been on and off the whole time. But the very last time they broke up, it was rumors going around about Chris putting his hands on Parker. So basically, it was rumors going around Instagram and all social media saying that Chris put his hands on Parker. People, all types of people was coming to Chris on social media and YouTube attacking him because they like, how can you put your hands on her? You're a cheater and a woman beater. Like, just coming at Chris. And Chris was denying all allegations. He was saying he never put his hands on Parker. He was saying that she's lying, like, he never put his hands on her. Don't believe everything y'all hear. Everybody want to make me out to be the bad guy, all this stuff. But and Parker, she was she never denied the allegations. Like, as soon as the rumors came out, she was ghost from social media. She was like, she barely posted. If she did, she didn't say anything about the rumors. She didn't speak anything about Chris. People would ask her questions, she would not answer them about the whole Chris situation. So, like, people wanted to know if she was okay, if the rumors were true, like, what was going on. We wanted to know the tea, sis, what's going on. But she wasn't answering, she was ghost. Finally, like, a week ago, she came out about the rumors. She basically went to the cops. Because the incident happened in Houston where they stayed, in an apartment they shared, and she went to the Houston Police Department and told them that Sales became enraged when he noticed a message on her phone from another man. He then began slapping her with an open hand and hitting her in the torso and other body parts. She also said that he punched her in her face with a closed fist, resulting in a black eye, and choked her till she couldn't breathe. I believe the rumors, and I was glad Parker finally came out with, you know, with her side of the story, exposing Chris, and with the proof she had. Parker did have pictures of her with a black eye, with bruises on her body and stuff. Chris says that the bruises come from they was fighting and they was arguing and she was hitting him and he was just trying to hold her down. The bruises come from him holding her down and trying to get her off of him and stuff. But nah, bruh, these bruises ain't just from holding down. Like, this girl, how do you explain the black eye and all the other bruises, like, all over her body? So she finally came out and, you know, told the police, and Chris was arrested for assault. So he's currently in jail for assault for beating Parker. I'm just glad Parker spoke up. She told her truth. She didn't let him get into her head. She wasn't scared. She spoke up and let them know what really happened and what really was going on. I wasn't surprised about the news at all, though, sorry to say, because Chris, he been angry since him and Queen broke up. He's an angry man, and he's been angry since he's been exposed for cheating. And when he got exposed, he lost a lot of fans, and the fans were attacking him. They still attacking him to this day about how he cheated on Queen. And he's been trying to still continue to do YouTube and stuff and funny videos, but he lost a lot of followers and he lost a lot of fans. And then on top of that, he mad that Queen moved on. She moved on to living her best life. Her singing career took off. She's been touring. She's been doing shows. She done had 2 singles hit top charts. Like, she living her best life. And she done moved on into a whole nother relationship with a whole nother man that loves her. And she's even pregnant right now, finna have another baby. She currently has a son with Chris, but she's finna have another baby with her new man, Clarence. And he's been angry from the beginning, since they broke up. So, I mean, the relationship he had with Parker wasn't gonna work out anyway, because he jumped right into that relationship after they broke up. He didn't have time to heal. He was angry. He don't want to admit he's angry, but that relationship was toxic from the beginning, because he went in there as an angry man who's mad at the world and mad at himself and mad that his ex-wife moved on and she's living a better life than he is now. So, of course, he took his anger out on Parker, because he seen a message from another man in her phone, went crazy, went off and put his hands on her. He's still denying these allegations. He's saying they're not true. Don't believe him. He never put his hand on her. But until it's some proof that you say you ain't put your hands on her, we going with what Parker say. I think it's crazy though, but I wasn't surprised at all with the news. And he already got a whole nother case going on now with him pretending to be a police officer in a prank video that he was doing. So he already got another ongoing case going on. So he just need to do his time in jail, because he got too much going on right now. Well, how y'all feel about this? I know it's a lot of Chris. There was a lot of Chris and Queen fans. So when they split up, that was hard for a lot of the fans. But everybody defended Queen, and they still defend the Queen to this day. Between the whole cheating allegations and the cheating scandal they had. So now he just lost even more fans with this woman beater scandal. Like, now you putting your hands on women. That ain't gonna work. But y'all, we're gonna take a quick break. I'm gonna play a song for y'all. It's gonna be Cardi B, Ring. Play a quick song, take a quick break, and we'll be back with the next topic.
You don't hear my life. I want to, but I got pride. Switching up is what I can't with. I'm feeling you, but you hard to get in touch with. And you ain't hit me up in a while. Acting like you don't know a number to dial. You quit, then that's it. I'ma throw in the towel. Cause I only gon' do what you allow. You don't want this gun smoke. Learn to text with your nose if your thumb broke. I don't care if we get into it and I stall on your air. But I still wake up to miss calls from your
head. You don't hear my line no more.
I'm looking at these messages, they on me. Acting like they ain't that want me. Let another nigga in your spot, and you gon' be hot, coffee. You gon' be sick to your stomach. Hit me when you free, 1-800. It's emergency, call me 911. Cause right now I'm out here tryna find someone. The ring on my phone, ring on my finger. You acting like you ain't tryna do either. What's a good girl? Watch me turn diva. Here goes my heart.
You don't hear my line no more. Oh, oh. Don't go
said, I just miss you, I just miss us, baby. All I know is you don't hear my line no more. Oh, oh.
Y'all, and we're back. That was Cardi B with Ring, and we're on to topic number 3, y'all. So this topic, we talking about Tyler Perry. I'm finna get y'all the tea. I love Tyler Perry. He's the creator of Madea. He makes those funny Madea movies. They're hilarious. So this tea is a little sad, y'all. If y'all love Madea and y'all love Tyler Perry, y'all gonna be a little sad with this news. According to an interview Tyler just did recently with Series XM radio host BB Smith, Tyler said that it's time to kill Madea. Y'all heard right, kill Madea. I couldn't believe it either. He trying to kill Madea, y'all. Come 2019, Madea would take her final bow in his upcoming film, Tyler Perry's Madea's Family Funeral. He said he just don't want to be her age playing her anymore. What's y'all thoughts on this? I'm real disappointed. I'm real mad. Tyler is known for being Madea. Madea is hilarious. Like, there would be no Tyler Perry without Madea. I know he going and he moving on to bigger and better things, bigger and better movies. But come on, Tyler, you can't kill Madea. You can't cancel her. What's going on? Like, I feel like Madea don't even be in nothing too crazy for her to get killed. How you just gonna make a funeral movie? How you just gonna kill her off the big screen? I'm confused. Like, I understand he's saying he don't want to be her age playing her no more. Nah, Tyler, what's the real tea, sis? You don't want to be your age playing her. That's how I feel. Tyler, just admit it, you getting too old to be jumping around, running and doing all that cursing with Madea. You gotta put on that big, you know, that fat suit. He gotta have the boobs. He gotta have the wig. He ain't with it no more. He tired, y'all. He tired. Tyler, just admit you tired. But we want Madea. We love Madea. We want Madea to stay. Like, I was really upset about this news. I could not believe that this is finna be the end of Madea come 2019, y'all. Like, no more Madea after that. That's his funniest movies. He does other great movies, but when Tyler does Madea, they are hilarious. Like, I can't believe he's just gonna kill Madea off, y'all. I just can't believe it. What y'all think about this, Tyler Perry fans, Madea fans? How y'all feel? Because I'm sad. That was a little bit of sad tea. I'm sad about that, y'all. But he moving on to bigger and better things. You know, he trying to get his coin, honey. And we understand. Get your coin. But you ain't got to kill Madea. So y'all make sure y'all go see that. That's going to be the last and final Madea movie come 2019. He ain't saying when it was going to be released. Or what month. Or whatever he just said in 2019. So we don't know when to expect it. We don't know if it's going to be early in the year or later. But that's going to be the last Madea film. So, you know, we all got to go out and support. And see that Madea film when it come out, y'all. Alright, y'all. Now let's get into Tamar Braxton, honey. Yes. Tamar, that's my girl. I love Tamar Braxton. Everybody thinks she extra, which she is, but that's what I love about her. So, y'all, let's get into this Tamar Braxton tea. So, y'all know Tamar living her best life right now, honey. Like, she got a new man, y'all. She ain't with Vince no more. Baby done left Vince. She got her a new man, a nice chocolate man that's... He ain't even from here. Like, I think he from, I forgot what she said he was. But I think he from the island. It's a nice island chocolate man. Like, she say she living her best life. She say she loves him. She say she in love, y'all. She say she in love with him. That's what she told Wendy Williams. But she say she out here living her best life. They having fun. He treats her right. He tells her how beautiful and young she looks. So she happy, y'all. And she just want to move on to her life and she want to be happy. So getting into this tea, basically Tamar asked the judge to sign off on her divorce since Vince has failed to respond to her petition for a divorce. According to the Shade Room, Tamar served Vince back on September 6th, and he was given 30 days to respond to in court. But Vince has failed to show up to court or file any court documents within that time period. So now Tamar is looking for a judge to finalize the divorce without him. Tamar said, "I ain't got time, honey." She said, "I don't got time, Vince. Vince, why is you playing these games? You ain't want to be with her no more. So why you playing games, Vince? Y'all was acting all different ways on the show. You saw when the relationship started falling apart on Tamar and Vince. Vince, you out here doing what you do. You mad she done moved on, Vince? You mad she living her best life? Let her move on to peace and be happy. What's up, Vince? What's the tea, Vince? Why you ain't went to court? Why you ain't signed these papers? Like, Tamar just wanted to live, honey. She just wanted to be happy. I feel Tamar. I feel her. I see where she coming from. I don't understand why people, they don't want to be together no more, or they unhappy in the relationship. And then when it's time to leave, you don't want to go. Like, when it's time to sign the divorce papers and it's time to get on with your life, y'all, they don't want to do it. Like, I'm confused. Why go through all that trouble? Why say you don't want to be in this marriage no more, but then you don't want me to be happy. You don't want me to move on. You trying to keep me trapped. Sign the papers, Vince. Just sign the papers, because nobody got time for all that. I feel Tamar, though. I feel she like, honey, we don't got time to play these games. He don't want to come to court. He don't want to show up to court. He don't want to sign these documents. We just going to find a judge to finalize this whole thing and get it done. We'll see how that go for Tamar. I don't know if a judge going to just sign off and finalize. They want him to be there. They going to find a way, but she got to do what she got to do. Live her best life, because, honey, she got her new man and a new young man, and she ain't trying to be held back. And she trying to have fun. I feel you, Tamar, girl. Alright, y'all. We back. Alright, let's get into the last topic of the day. And y'all already know what it should be. I saved the best for last. The best tea for last. And that is the Nicki versus Cardi. What side y'all on? Who y'all pick? Are you team Nicki or team Cardi? Which one y'all is? Honestly, I love both. I can't even pick. I'm a Nicki fan. Always been a Nicki fan since Nicki came out, Nicki Minaj. And I'm a Cardi B fan. Why do we have to choose? Why can't y'all just get along? Like, come on, guys. So we know it's been so much tea, so much drama and beef going back over social media between Cardi and Nicki, and between the fans. We got the fans beefing now. Nicki fans, the Barbs, and then we got Cardi B fans. Everybody beefing. So basically, y'all, let me give y'all the tea, the recent tea that just happened this week regarding Nicki and Cardi. So Nicki and Cardi have been going back and forth on Instagram about what really happened that night at the gala event. Nicki goes on Queen Radio, her own show, Queen Radio, and said that Cardi went home and lied and said security hit her. She went home, she was trying to be big and bad, and you know she had to let people know she didn't want to look like a punk, and let people know, like, nah, bro, security hit me, that's why this bump on my head. So, but not Nicki saying that's not true. They said they let Cardi go on with this lie and let everybody believe this lie because Nicki say that she didn't want to be sued. And the reason she said that is because Nicki says the truth is that Ra Ali beat Cardi so bad. She was like, she was punching Cardi in the face. Blows to the face. Beating Cardi so bad that she didn't want anybody to try to sue her because she's the one with the money. This is what Nicki said on Queen Radio. So basically, Nicki saying all that stuff Cardi been saying is lies, lies, and lies. And she tired of Cardi coming for her. And she tired of everybody attacking Ra. Now she said, now everybody calling Ra a liar. And she's like, Ra's not lying. Ra did beat her behind. And Cardi's making everybody believe that security was the one that hit her. But really, it was Ra Ali. And then Nicki goes on to say that she'll give anybody a stack if they basically can pull the surveillance video. She's like, pull the surveillance video at the night at the event. Anybody who pull it, I pay y'all this amount of money if y'all leak the video. Saying like, so she like, show what really happened so the fans can know, because I'm tired of all this beef that's going on, the back and forth. So everybody like, oh, Nicki said this, Cardi really got her behind wood, blah blah blah. So then Cardi gets wind of this interview that Nicki is doing on her show, and Cardi goes to make, you know, a few videos and post them on Instagram. And Cardi says that Nicki is lying, that Riley did not beat her up. Cardi said, it's so much video footage out of that night from different angles, and you don't see Ra Ali hitting her in none of them. She basically saying, girl, what you need surveillance footage for? Like, it's so many videos. People, everybody around was recording, and she's like, all the video footage y'all seen Ra was nowhere near me. Y'all know she ain't put her hands on me. You know she ain't hit me. She like, where the footage at then, since Ra beat my behind so bad? Should be some type of footage of her beating me so bad then, if she really did. That's what Cardi's saying, basically. And then Cardi says that Nicki lies so much she can't even keep her lies straight. She said that Cardi need to pick a side. Do you want to be a gangster or you want to be the victim? She says she constantly playing the victim, and then she wants to be a gangster at the same time. She went to play the victim and said, oh, you stopping my bag. Oh, you doing this. Oh, Cardi fans attacking me. Cardi fans talking about me. Cardi's sister doing this, doing that. But she like, but then you want to get on your radio show and you want to talk mess and you want to be a gangster and you want to be about it. And you want to say that this is what y'all did. Your friend beat me up, and you want to say, well, we can do this, we can do that. But Cardi like, girl, stop. Do you want to be the victim or you want to be a gangster? Because you're not going to do nothing. Cardi been saying, girl, you always doing all this talking. So what it's about? Y'all, I'm just giving y'all the backstory of the whole Cardi versus Nicki beef. I'm not taking sides. I'm not saying who's right, who's wrong. They both wrong in the situation, really. But, I mean, I understand where they both coming from. I like Cardi and Nicki, so I can't choose. I just think the whole situation is crazy and funny at the same time. But this rap beef have to stop between women, because if the men can coexist together in the rap biz, why can't the women? Why it always has to be some type of petty drama? Can y'all squash the petty beef and move on with y'all lives? Can y'all do a record together without beefing? Can y'all just get this money together, or just learn to coexist in the same industry and just, you know, don't say nothing bad about one another. Just do you. Like, put it in the music. I don't know. How y'all feel about this? Yeah, everybody say Nicki always beefing with everybody. She was beefing with Remy, then she was beefing with Lil' Kim, then she was beefing with, she's beefing with everybody. They say Nicki always starting stuff with other people because she want to be on top by herself. She don't want nobody. She mad when other people get the glory and get the limelight and the shine. But how y'all feel? I don't know. Because it is a lot of back and forth. And Nicki do be going back and forth with a lot of people. But this story, I don't know who to believe, because they keep going back and forth. And I'm like, where's the receipts? Both of them keep saying y'all bringing receipts. Where's the receipts, sis? We need the receipts so we know who lying and who telling the truth. We want to know the tea. We want to know the real. We want to know what's going on, honey. We need the receipts. Stop saying y'all bringing receipts and there's no receipts, honey. We need to see the video footage of what really happened. Did Cardi really get her behind whooped, or was it all a lie? Was Nicki really standing on the wall scared? And was Cardi really hit by the security guards? We need the tea, sis. Where's the receipts? Somebody bring the receipts up. Nicki said she'll pay y'all, so somebody bring the real footage. We need to know. That's all I'm saying. We need to know, honey, so we can solve this for once and for all, and they can stop this back and forth beef. But at the end of the day, they both agreed to basically stop going back and forth, and that they just gonna drop it, leave it alone. They did all this back and forth the whole day, going back and forth about nothing. And in the end, they decided they was just gonna stop talking about it. Like, y'all was talking so much back and forth, like, we was waiting to see if somebody was gonna square up. What was really going on? So, I know it's some Nicki fans and Cardi B fans out there. How y'all feel about this situation? Is y'all team Cardi, team Nicki? Which one y'all is? But you know, like I said, I ain't taking sides, y'all. So don't come for me. I ain't taking sides. I'm just letting y'all know what the tea is and the latest drama between Cardi and Nicki. But yeah, long as that footage get leaked, we need somebody to leak the footage that was at the event. If you work in the surveillance office, if you were security, you know, put the video out, y'all. We need to know the tea. But that's it for this week, guys. Thanks for tuning in. This has been Jada with the Tea. And until next time, we're going to go out with one more song. And I hope you guys continue to tune in. Thanks. Bye.
One I see.